We're going to break them up into three categories and talk about movements within each of those categories. First category, we'll call weightlifting. What movements fall underneath that category? Give me some.
Deadlift.
Deadlift, yep. Deadlift. Basically all of the stuff that we did picking stuff up off the ground. Deadlift, sumo deadlift, high pull, clean, thruster would fall under this category. All of our presses fall underneath this category. What else? Snatch would fall underneath this category. All our kettlebell work. So let's talk kettlebell swings. We didn't do those this weekend. Wall ball. Wall ball would be on here. The movement you guys did in Fight Gone Bad. Let's talk about movements we wouldn't want to see in there. So I mentioned all the machine movements. How about something like the Turkish getup? Would we want to see that in there? Who says yes? Who says no? Anyone say no? Why do you say no?
Well, I think it's more gymnastics.
Why do you say no?
Slow.
Yeah, that's the key right there. The Turkish getup is a challenging move, correct? It takes a lot of stabilization, and it is a good, we'll call, core movement. But now with the Turkish getup, are we moving a large load? Are we moving a large load? Generally speaking, no. Not compared to how we can move loads by other means. Are we moving it a long distance? Yeah, we're moving it a long distance. Are we moving it quickly though? No, not at all. So as soon as you start doing Turkish get-ups, really slow movement, you're losing that aspect of power. You're losing where we want to go. So what am I saying? Am I saying don't ever do Turkish get-ups? No, what I'm saying is program a workout using these functional movements, but maybe in your warm-up or maybe in post-workout, especially if you're a kettlebell guy or you like Turkish get-ups, that's when you can do Turkish get-ups, before or after.